I'll talk about it.
Obviously,
it's been almost 25 years that this tombstone has had the wrong birth year on it. How that happened, I have no idea. It makes no sense. I don't know how you couldn't know your husband's birth year, but okay.
It's just a simple mistake.
It's not a simple mistake. Our dad is Eazy. There's no such thing as a simple mistake.
What's up, peeps, and welcome back to the Lionel B Show. If it's your first time tuning into the channel, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on the videos, man. And if y'all are not receiving my brand new upload notifications, make sure you go to my channel where it says subscribe and change the bell to all instead of personalized. Also, make sure you don't forget to follow me on Instagram at @officiallionelb and follow my other YouTube channel, Lionel B Unleashed. So it looks like Eazy-E's daughter, Ebby, is not going for the games when it comes to her pop legendary rapper from NWA, Eric Wright, a.k.a. Eazy-E. Now today, man, DJ Speed NWA took to the gram and he actually clapped at Eazy-E's daughter for throwing shade about his headstone. So I'm going to give y'all a little bit of explanation so once y'all watch the video, y'all can understand what's exactly going on. So basically, man, Eazy-E, he had a new headstone unveiling. And apparently, for a long time, she said 25 years plus, his birth date was wrong. And he blames Eazy-E's wife for not having the right year on there. You know, and of course, like, that would hurt somebody. Like, damn, like, how is that? How do you make a mistake like that? So DJ Speed NWA, he had a couple of things to say about Eazy-E's daughter. And he was like, yo, she thinks she's better than everything. And he was basically clapping at her. And I'm sure the OG Eazy-E would not be happy about that. So I'm going to show y'all the clip real quick. And we're going to get into what he was actually saying about the craziness. Check this out.
A lot of you guys for coming out today to celebrate with us, experiences, witnesses. It's been a long road coming for us as siblings. We're all adults now. This is something we wanted to give back to my dad. Yes, I did forefront it, but this is something that my siblings wanted for years and years to come. We wanted to share with all of you guys as well. I can't wait for you guys to see it. No one has seen it besides me. Tim. I want to introduce you guys to Tim.
Tim. Let's go, Tim.
On Cemetery Tim, I design headstones for families all across the country. And I just want to say, today it's a true honor to do this and be a part of this for the Wright family and for all the fans, really, all over the country. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Tim.
Happy to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Obviously, it's been almost 25 years that this tombstone has had the wrong birth year on it. How that happened, I have no idea. It makes no sense. I don't know how you couldn't know your husband's birth year, but okay.
It's just a simple mistake.
It's not a simple mistake. Our dad is Eazy-E. There's no such thing as a simple mistake.
There we go.
Again,
Mama didn't tell you it was a mistake by the printer.
It shouldn't have taken 25 years to change. This is a legend. This is our father. It should have been done as soon as we asked. I know my sister really fought for it for many, many, many years. And she really had to do some things to make this really happen. And without even knowing if it really was supposed to be done or not. But this is the right thing to have been done. It should, like I said, should have been many years ago. We're so excited about this today. To me, I think his next thing, he needs an even bigger brand situation going on top of this, or maybe even moving him into somewhere special that he deserves.
Because of the atmosphere that he's in, this section, they said it couldn't be.
Yeah.
It couldn't stand up. That's something we wanted for years, something that we have asked for. It couldn't stand up in this section. Sharan knows that we have called in before. Sharan even said, you want to move him? No, we're not going to move him. That's crazy. So he's here. We couldn't have him standing, so me and Tim got together. We try to do the best we could.
And I'm so proud of you. We're so proud of you.
I hope you guys are happy for it, Grandma. The tombstone that we had before. Yes. It was really humble. I appreciate it. It was still 24 years. I mean, it lay here for 24 years. It still means something to me with the right or the wrong thing. But this is something that I feel represented my daddy more and stands off. So this is something that he actually deserved as the man himself.
Now, we can understand somebody getting a raggedy behind headstone, and let alone somebody having the wrong birth date of the person that's laying there and they're unable to get it changed for 25, 24 years. Now, DJ Speed NWA, he came back. He said, man, if you saw and heard the things they have said about me over the years are about as bad as this video. And anyone who wants to talk dirty on my name from saying I stole from Eric, which I never have, to I'm a nobody, they're not angels. I'm just not scared to call them out. They basically tried to use me to help them with the documentary. That's a whole other story. So people need to stop thinking I'm the one tripping. I'm just the one who will go overboard to make sure Eric is not disrespected. He treated me like a son. I watched all those kids grow up, some from birth. So people need to understand I have a connection with this family. I'm not an outsider. He also came in and said, they move different. They are better than everyone else. So they think. Also, he said, Jerry didn't give anyone to Eric. He just brainwashed them both because they weak-minded. Now, that sounds very personal. It sounds like, okay, you're not really necessarily just defending Eazy-E. You're personally going to his children, like, which is crazy, which, you know, I understand some of them may not be angels, like you said. However, that's their father, not your father. But apparently there's some stories out there saying that he was stealing from Eric. But also he's going at Jerry Keller saying, hey, you know, he brainwashed the kids for whatever reason. But you know what? A dead man cannot speak on what happened and what did not happen. So kind of strange situation, man. I'm going to play the rest of the funeral. It's just cringeworthy, man. And the fact that the DJ even came out and he wanted to drag her and put her on blast, it's kind of crazy, y'all. Check out the rest of the video.
First and foremost, let's go back to what my grandmother said.
It was a what? It was a mistake, right? So with the thing that I learned her, you take the bitter with the sweet. The time will come to where we needed to change it. What I want to happen is, just as all we are together as his kids, this is what we need to do for this change to come. If we're not going to be together and we're always going to be separated, therefore, a lot of stuff can't get done. One wants to do one thing, one wants to do another, some other wants to do other things. So therefore, this should sit here and also be something to where we keep ourselves together. As we came together for his birthday, we should continue doing this as we are rights. Love each other as we're supposed to,
right?
As he rewarded us to. You know what I'm saying? So again, it was a mistake. Until we could be old enough to come together as we should, this is what's done. It was given to Erica.
Correct. A whole lot of mistakes that need to be corrected.
We don't know what we're going to do with all of that at a different time. Right now, it's my dad's birthday. Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Right now, this is my dad's day. I want to acknowledge my dad. We're going to give thanks to my dad. This is only the beginning.
Yes.
It's been a long road, but we're here.
Can we see it?
Definitely sad that it took that long for him to get a proper headstone. And also, so many successful members from NWA at no point was like, hey, you know what? Our brother deserves a better headstone. You got Dr. Dre worth almost $1 billion. He had a $1 billion Apple deal. He never fixed it. Ice Cube, he got millions and millions, you know, owner of Big Three, mad money in the bank. He never fixed it. Definitely crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? Got to get people their flowers while they're here and also when they're gone. So y'all let me know how y'all feel about this. How do y'all feel about his daughter stepping up and calling foul on everybody that didn't treat her dad right while he was here and while he was gone? And also, like, why was there a mistake with the headstone and why did it take so long to get it fixed? Y'all let me know how y'all feel about this, man. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on the videos. Share these videos, and I'm going to peep y'all on the next one. Holla.